Good morning, Live Church. Good morning, everybody. We are welcoming you here at Live Church. We're not having an actual service this morning. We are going live streaming. So just want to open up with a scripture this morning. Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 13 says, "You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart." And this morning, I think that rings true more now than ever. And that, of course, that is we need to seek the Lord in every way. During this time of distress for many people, we are just trusting in the Lord, trusting God. So we're just praying for you during these times, and we just know that God's going to give us the victory, and we're thanking him now for health and his provision over our lives. And we just thank you for tuning in this morning, and we just we're going to start with worship, but before we do that, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank you, Lord, for this day, God. We thank you, Lord, for this time to gather together, Lord, even if it's over social media. We just pray, God, for each and every person, God, that's listening or that will listen, God, later on today or later on this week. God, we pray for peace over their life, God, for joy in their spirits, Father. We just ask you, Lord, that you be with them, God, in everything that they do, everywhere they go. God, we come against this virus, and God, we just take authority over it in the name of Jesus. And God, we thank you for the peace of God that surpasses all understanding. And Lord, we just ask you, Lord, for your blessings on this worship time today and on this gathering. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's worship together.
Shaking in the name of Jesus, enemies are defeated. Jesus save.
Got you.
Thank you. than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. In Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the storm, He is known, born alone. When darkness seems to hide His face, I rest on His unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within me there.
So good to be in God's house this morning with all the chaos and everything that's going on that we're here. And if you're watching us over live streaming this morning, just know that there's anointing in this place, just as if there's anointing in your home right now. And It's kind of awkward to be preaching to chairs. The thing is that I know where everybody sits, so I just pretend that you're sitting there this morning. So you're here with us. Even though you're in your homes, you're here with us because I know where you sit at. And we're just going to trust God with what he's doing this morning. Appreciate everybody that if you're not part of Life Church, but you're watching this morning, we just hope and pray that you're just get a blessing today. You'll be encouraged this morning with God's word. And we know that he is our strength. He is our power. He is our everything. And we're just going to trust him with all that he had for us. So we're going to get into the word this morning. The word that God's given me this morning is that peace that passes all understanding. And turn your Bibles to John chapter 14. So, Father, right now in Jesus' name, as we prepare to get in your word this morning, Father God, we thank you for the anointing that's in this house, this anointing that's in these homes that's watching this morning, Father God. I know that everyone wished that they were here. They were in their church, Father God. But, Lord, we are the church. It's no matter where we're at, church is going on, Father God. And I just thank you right now for the anointing that's in this place and your love that's here. Guide us and direct us through this service as we get into your word now, Father God. The word that you've put in my heart for us today. May we become not just hearers of the word, but become the doers of the word that will bring glory and honor to you today, Father God. And we thank you, we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. We just give God praise for what he's going to do this morning. We're just going to just jump into the word and go with it this morning. So I want us to look in John chapter 4. I want to begin in verse 15. Now this is where Jesus comforts his disciples and then goes down and Jesus promises the Holy Spirit here. This is where we want to pick it up. In verse 15 of John chapter 4, it says, "If you love me, you will obey what I command. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another counselor to be with you forever, the Spirit of truth. The world cannot accept him because it neither sees him nor knows him, but you know him, for he lives with you and will be in you." It says, if you love me, you will obey my commands. We love God, so we want to obey his commands. And what happens? He has promised us the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit that's not full of power, but the Holy Spirit that's full of healing, full of strength, full of peace that we need to have. And so Jesus left and he says, I'm going to give you a counselor. I'm going to give you the Holy Spirit. And then we can drop down to verse 25. And it says, all this I have spoken while still with you. But the counselor, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and remind you everything I have said to you. And this is the word I want us to get a hold of this morning. Peace I live with you. I leave with you. My peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid. Jesus says, peace I leave with you, peace I give with you. I've got to be honest with you today. I think Christians struggle in life. We believe, we trust in Jesus, but our problem comes when we forget about that peace that passes all understanding. And we so easily get burdened down with worry that causes us to become fearful. You know, right now, I've listened to so many news stations, I've listened to everything, and everybody seems to have a different appearance of this coronavirus. And there's a lot of negative, a lot of fearful stuff being put out there. And as Christians, we've got to get to that place where we become peaceful with all that fear that's trying to be put on us. You know, this comes with heartaches of life. I've got to let everybody in a little secret. Becoming a Christian, when we became a Christian, it did not set us free from all the troubles in this world. Okay?
Well, Pastor, I don't know about you, but when I became a Christian and I gave my life to Jesus, I was set free from all these troubles
that's in this world. No, I got to burst your bubble. No, you were not. We were not set free from the troubles. But the good news is that we were set free from the anxiety, from the fear, from the worry that comes with those troubles. The troubles are going to come, but we don't have to take the fear. We don't have to take the anxiety. We don't have to take the worry. We don't have to take that stuff. The troubles come, but because they're going, after the coronavirus, guess what? There's going to be something else that's going to happen in. There's something else after that. It's been like this since the time, and it's going to continue like that. Something is always going to be troubling in this world. And that's why we have to trust God and have the peace that God gives us. It says, peace I leave with you, my peace. Whose peace? Jesus' peace that he gives us. Well, see, the world tries to put this worry, this anxiety, this fear on us. But the thing is, we don't have to take it. We don't have to walk in it. So why is it so difficult to not worry or to walk in fear or to have anxiety? Could it be that things may not go the way we want them to? And because of that, the problem is we can't control the situation. And that's when it becomes difficult to walk. See, we would rather control the situations ourselves. Well, we got to give these situations, we got to give these things over to God, but we're trying to handle them ourselves. Our thinking is, the more anxious or worried I become, the more control I have. The thing is, the less we are in control, the more worried we become. How hard is it for us to let go and begin to let God do the worrying? And I can tell you right now, God don't worry. But he wants to take our worries away from us. And we have to give them to him. And in Philippians 4, 6 through 9, and this is the Message translation. I love this translation. It says, don't fret or worry. Instead of worrying, pray. Let petitions and praise shape your worries into prayers. Letting God know your concerns, before you know it, a sense of God's wholeness, everything coming together for good will come, settle you down. You know, it's wonderful what happens when Christ displaces worry at the center of your life. This is the promise from God. If you're not anxious for anything, and you're praying with thanksgiving, letting your request be made to God, this is the key. We've got to begin to pray. We've got to begin to give our request over to God. Anything that is heavy on your heart, anything troubling you, wearing you down, all we have to do is, and God says, then pray about it. The promise is the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. This worry, this fear is in our midst right now through this coronavirus. Everybody's fearful. Everybody's worrying about it. You know, now I can play around with this fear. I can play around with this worry, or I can choose to give this worry, to give this fear, this anxiety over to God. And I don't have to try to control my situation. I turn them over to God. Now, let me say this. What I'm teaching you and preaching today is I'm right here with everybody. All right, when you watch this stuff on news, you fear just automatically wants to come and jump on you. Worry just wants to come in. Do we have enough food? Do we have enough of this? You know, are we going to get it? Are we going to catch it? And all these things go through our minds. But we've got to have the peace of God that comes in and takes over our mind, takes over our hearts, and we give everything over to God. I choose to give God my fear. I choose to give God my worry. God is saying to us today, what are you worrying about? What is it that you're so worried about? He says, here, give it to me. What are you afraid of today? Give it to me. You give that to me, and he says, I'll give you something. What is that something he gives us? He says, I'll give you my peace. That peace that passes all understanding. See, this is a an exchange in the spiritual realm that God gives us. Jesus said, come to me, all who are weary and burdened. So what's the first exchange? Is we go to Jesus. We go to Jesus. What's the second exchange? What do we get out of it? And he says, I will give you rest. I will give you the peace that you need to have. It's an exchange. I go to Jesus, and Jesus gives me the peace. Second part of the exchange, Jesus stands there, and he says, I'm ready to help. See, and the thing is, he won't force himself on us, but he does stand there ready for us to come and say, Lord, here. Lord, I want to give you my fear. Lord, I want to give you my worry. Lord, I want to give you my anxiety. I'm not sleeping tonight. I'm not able to do this. I can't eat. I can't that because I'm so busy watching this news. I'm so busy watching everything that it's just putting fear in me. We got to begin to pray more and worry less. And Oswald Chambers, in his devotional book, he wrote, are you obsessed with something? And he goes on to say that we are to be obsessed only by the presence of God. And if I'm obsessed by something, I will be thinking of it all the time. Throughout the day, in the night, he says, I'll even dream about it. Now, if we are so conscious of God's presence all the time, nothing else can get into my life, not worries and not concerns. George Mueller said, the beginning of anxiety is the end of faith, and the beginning of faith is the end of anxiety. I love that. See, if I worry, that means I need to pray more. By praying more, you worry less. I mean, it's just addiction there. You can't help but know that if I pray more, I'm going to worry less. And if I worry more, that means I'm praying less. And we just got to begin to pray more. See, if we're praying about everything, then we won't need to be anxious about anything. Henry Blackaby, in his book, Experiencing God, I remember back in the 90s, early 90s, I took a youth ministry through this book, and it's a tremendous study book. But he said, as you no doubt have discovered, becoming a Christian does not make your problems go away, but it does give you an advocate to whom you can take your concerns to. They don't go away, but what happens? We're sent the Holy Spirit. We have the presence of God. We have an advocate in heaven that's interceding on our behalf. Listen, church, we have to understand, if God can handle this whole universe, can he not handle any problem that comes up in this world? Can he not handle the coronavirus? What is this peace that Jesus gives us? It's that same peace that Jesus had. What was that peace? In Matthew 16, Jesus told his disciples that he had to go to Jerusalem. And he had to suffer many things. And one of those things was he was to be killed and raised the third day. Boy, Peter stands up and tries to stop him and say, Lord, you can't go back there. They're out to kill you. You can't do that. And what does Jesus immediately say? Satan, get thee behind me. I never want to hear those words from Jesus on me. All right? He says, you're a stumbling block to me. You do not have the things in mind of God, but the things of men. See, if we're listening to men and we're and women, and we're hearing this, all these negative stuff. And so am I going to be obedient to them? Listen, they can only tell us what they know. But I know who's telling me the truth, and that's my God. I stay upon his word. I trust his word, and I pray, and I trust in him. Men can only tell you what they know, but I know who I'm trusting in, and that's my God. Jesus had a peace about his death. When the time came, Jesus was ready to go to face that cross. See, in that garden, he resolved the problem. He said, Father, not my will, but Father, your will be done. He resolved the problem right then. Lord, I'm going to trust you, and I'm going to go and do what you told me to do. He knew that there would be pain. He knew there would be trouble. But he was at peace because he knew his Father God was with him. Church, this same peace is the same peace that Jesus has promised each and every one of us. This peace allows us to be able to say, it is well with my soul. Even if it doesn't make any sense, this peace that passes all understanding, even though I can't explain it, there's no way I can explain this peace. All I know is this peace is inside of me. And this peace will get me through whatever troubles, whatever problems I'm going through. It will get me through this fear. It will get me through this anxiety. It will get me through this worry. This peace that when everything around you seems to be falling apart, guess what? You're not. Everything else is like, man, I can't, you know, but you just got this peace about it. And people say, don't you see what's happening? Don't you care? Yeah, but you got to understand, I've got this peace inside of me because it's well with my soul. Listen, I can't explain it. All I know is because of him, it's going to be okay. See, the world looks at you in this amazement. You yourself is even amazed because you can't explain it. All you know is it's because of him. It's because of Jesus who lives inside of me. It's Jesus who said, peace, I leave with you. Peace, I give you. Peace that passes all understanding. This peace that I get because the Holy Spirit is inside of me. We know what Psalms 46 says. God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the sea, the waters roar and foam and the mountains quake with their surging. When the world goes crazy around us, the mountains quake and fall apart. The sea is strong and full of foam, but there is this peace. Verse 4 says, there is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. See, church, this river brings us peace. Rest is inside of us that are children of the Most High God. There's this peace, a peace that can only come from Jesus, who said, peace I leave with you, peace I give you. See, I think the key to this peace is that Jesus gives us, and the key to it is we must take it. We must take it. We need to claim this peace that Jesus leaves with us. You know, there's a story where Jesus is on a boat and they cast out into a sea and a storm comes and Jesus is fast asleep. And the disciples are freaking out. They don't know what's going on. And these are trained fishermen that's been on the waters, and the waves are beating it against the boat, and they're just fearful, and they go to Jesus. And this is what amazes me. The storm doesn't wake Jesus up. They have to go and wake Jesus up because he has this peace. He knows who his Father is. And they come to him and say, Master, Lord, don't you know? Don't you care if we die? Jesus doesn't say anything, just gets up and says, peace, be still. And the storm stops. The waves go back to normal because of that word, peace. We have that peace. See, the same peace is given to us. And all we have to do is take it. All we have to do is take it. You know, Peter stepped out of the boat. He had a peace when he stepped out of that boat. When there stormed all around him, he had this peace because he had his eyes on Jesus. But the peace left when he took his eyes off of Jesus and he began to sink. And Jesus picked him up and took him back to the boat. As long as we have our eyes on Jesus, we should have this peace inside of us. a peace that passes all understanding. When these storms come in our life, this same peace that came from the lips of Jesus is that same peace that should come from our lips. Peace. Be still. I've got to say, God's got this. Now, I'm to walk in wisdom. We are to walk in wisdom. We are to walk in knowledge. Don't go out and do anything crazy. But we are to have this peace that God's in control. God's going to control everything. God is going to, let me say, God is in control of this church. And we just have to have that peace and not do anything crazy, but just walk in that peace. If you start worrying, just begin to pray more. And just pray that peace out, because pray that fear out, pray that anxiety out, pray that worry out. Because you pray more, you're strengthened more. And that's all God is waiting. He's waiting for his children to pray to him and say, bring me your concerns. Bring me your fear. Bring me your anxiety. Bring me your worry. Bring me these things to me and give them to me so that you can walk in peace. See, we have trouble walking in peace if we have all this fear in us. If we have all this anxiety. We get the peace when we give everything over to Jesus. How do we keep this peace in our hearts during this storm and the storms that will follow after this? Comes through three things: prayer, worship, and praise. I believe through this time, we need to be praising, we need to be worshiping our God, we need to be praying to our God. Listen, we should be giving him thanks. You know, one thing I see through this is causing the church to start getting outside the box. It's causing the church to do things abnormal, the way they usually don't do it, like we're doing this morning. I love it when I see a church that's doing a drive-through service, a drive-in service. I've seen all these unique ways of people still getting the word. Churches are coming up with ways that God's given them to get the word out. God's given us this technology. This is kind of getting us outside the walls, from our seats to the streets. And ministering the word of God. Listen, we need to be the encouragement to this world. Walk in wisdom, but be the encouragement to this world. Let people know that, hey, you can have this same peace that I have. Hey, am I saying that fear is not going to try to come? Worry is not going to come? No, I'm not saying that. But I'm saying we have a creator. We have a mighty God. We have the Holy Spirit. You shall receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you to be a witness. How can we be a witness? By telling people about the peace of God. This peace that passes all understanding. We got to keep focused on Jesus. And we got to keep focused on his promise that says, I leave you my peace. I give you my peace. And do not let your hearts be troubled. And do not be afraid. I want to encourage everyone, those that are listening this morning. Listen, you can have this peace of God that passes all understanding. All you have to do is say yes to Jesus. I don't know if you're born again. I don't know if you're a Christian. I don't know if you're walking with God. Maybe you have been walking to God, but you've gotten away from God. This is your day to get back with God. This is your day to give your life over to Jesus Christ that wants to give you this peace. And all you have to do is just ask Jesus into your heart. He says, I am the way, the truth, and the life, that no man can go to the Father except through me. We can only go through Jesus. No, there's no other way into the kingdom of God. I don't care. There's only one way, and that's through Jesus Christ. And today, he wants to come into your heart. So I want to ask right now, if you want Jesus into your heart, we're going to say a little prayer. And I want you to ask Jesus into your heart. Maybe you've been away from God, and today you've decided, I need to get back with God. I want to have this peace that passes all understanding. I want this peace that can only come through Jesus Christ. So let's bow our heads and pray. Father God, right now, I just ask that you could bring a peace upon your children today, Father God. This peace that you have left with us, this peace that you've given us, a peace that we can walk and have to share with others. That when the whole world is falling apart, we can have this peace of standing firm in your word, Father God. And if you're never giving your life over to Jesus, I want to give you an opportunity right now. I want you to say, Jesus, come into my heart right now. I ask forgiveness of my sins. And I want to live for you, Father God. I want to have this peace that passes all understanding. So I thank you, Father, right now for Jesus who died on that cross for me, who gave his life on that cross for me. And I accept him right now as my Savior, as my Lord, as my Master. And I'm going to walk in this peace and give you the praise and the glory for it, Father, right now. In Jesus' name, amen. My prayer for you this morning is that through this time, that you'll walk with the peace that God has given us. A peace that he has left with us, a peace that he has given us. When everything is going on, with all the chaos going on, with all the news that's going on, we can still walk with this peace, knowing that God is in control of my life. I don't have to walk in anxiety. I don't have to walk in fear. I don't have to walk in worry. Yes, those things are going to come, but we don't have to walk in them. We've got something greater than the coronavirus. We've got the blood of Jesus Christ, the best vaccine you could ever have. It kills every bacteria. And we can walk in victory every day. And you can have that victory. Just every morning get up and say, Lord, I want to trust you this morning. Lord, I'm bringing my concern to you. And I'm turning everything over to you this morning, Father. And just get up. Be encouraged. And just stay close with God. And give him all that you have, all your concerns, all your, give everything over to him. Because he loves us so much. He loves us so much. Just sit up into your daddy's lap and say, Daddy, I got a fear. Daddy, I'm worried. And I can just see God putting his arms around you and saying, it's okay, child, I love you. It's okay, hon, I've got control. I'm here for you. I'm here to protect you. Amen. So, Father, right now in Jesus' name, as we are in our homes, I just pray that within our families right now, Father God, those who are watching, that you begin to pray with one another. You'll begin to encourage one another. Love on one another. Let the manifestation of the Holy Spirit show up in every home. And let your glory shine in every one of these homes, Father God, that will draw us even closer to you, Father God. Because you want to love on us so much. Because you care about us so much. And we thank you, Father, for this opportunity to give this word today. May we hear what the Spirit of the Lord was speaking to us today, to have that peace that passes all understanding, that will bring glory to you, Father God. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. For those who are listening, this Wednesday night, we do not have a service, but Pastor Jason will be live streaming it this coming Wednesday night at 7 o'clock. So you need to be watching. Great teacher, great man of God. So I want to encourage you to tune in this Wednesday night on live streaming on Facebook. And we give God praise and glory. We love you. I want to encourage you to stay and just walk with God and give everything over to him. We love you. God bless.